Right now, Governor Tony Evers is taking steps to change Wisconsin policing.
And a stormy setup could be on the table for next week. We have what you need to know in the First Alert forecast.
This is News 3 Now This Morning.
Good Thursday morning, everybody. Thanks for waking up with us. I'm Leah Lynch-Eyde.
And I'm Chris Stanford. The results in the case against former officer Derek Chauvin sparking some new changes in policing in Wisconsin. A new executive order from Governor Evers directs state-managed law enforcement to review and update their use of force policies. That includes the Capitol Police, State Patrol, and DNR, among others. The governor says the state will lead by example and set the bar.
Now, along with Governor Evers' order, a state task force is offering up 18 different recommendations for police oversight. The group was created after the shooting of Jacob Blake in Kenosha. The recommendations stop short of banning chokeholds and no-knock warrants. They also don't establish a statewide definition for use of force. Here are some of the key recommendations. Officers could face criminal charges for not stepping in when they see other officers use excessive force. They would also face new reasons to be decertified and have mandatory psychological evaluations in order to get a job in law enforcement. We're also learning new information this morning about the murder-suicide that happened in Watertown last week.
Authorities say retired Watertown police officer Douglas Teutenberg killed his teenage son, then took his own life. Watertown police say they were called to check on the welfare of Teutenberg Friday. They tried calling him, then went to his house and found Teutenberg and his 16-year-old son dead. Since Teutenberg was a former Watertown police officer, police contacted the Dodge County Sheriff's Office to investigate. On the heels of the Derek Chauvin conviction, the Justice Department now launching a federal civil probe into policing practices in Minneapolis. Attorney General Merrick Garland says the investigation will determine whether the department has a pattern or practice of unconstitutional or unlawful policing. The AG says it will include a comprehensive review of the department's policies, training, supervision, and use of force investigations.
The city of Norfolk, Virginia has fired a police lieutenant for reports he donated to and expressed support for Kyle Rittenhouse. City officials announced that Police Lieutenant William Kelly had been relieved of duty after an internal investigation. The city manager called remarks Kelly apparently made in support of Rittenhouse egregious. Kelly can appeal that firing.
If you're still looking for a vaccine appointment in Dane County, more spots are opening up. Vaccine appointments at the Alliant Energy Center aren't filling up, so now they are trying to reach people who might not be as eager to get a vaccine. Public health isn't alone. Many vaccinators in the area are also noticing a slowdown in demand. UW Health's Dr. Matt Anderson says it's time to shift their approach.
Starting to get into maybe some people who are either less motivated or they're a little less sure. There is a really strong need. We need as many people as possible to take that advantage of being vaccinated so we can get that herd immunity, so we can get rid of COVID transmission in the community as much as possible.
Dr. Anderson says if we don't reach herd immunity as quick as possible, we'll see even more variants of COVID.
Overseas, many countries are still struggling with a rise in cases. India recorded a little over 300,000 new COVID cases this morning. That's a global record. The country is in the middle of a second wave. It's also dealing with a shortage of oxygen in its hospitals as its healthcare system becomes more overwhelmed.
The Federal Trade Commission says phone scams are the most common type of scam in the U.S.
And right now, the Dane County Sheriff's Office is sending out an alert about one hitting our area. Taylor Lazenby is live in studio this morning with that call for action. Hi, Taylor.
Hi, guys. Good morning. That's right. Dane County Sheriff's Office says they have recently received a high call volume for scams for callers impersonating the Sheriff's Department. Scammers are calling citizens, telling them that their family member or loved one has been in an accident and arrested, and they will not be released until a large sum of cash is provided for bond. In addition, someone on the line will also pose as an attorney and tell them not to speak to anyone else about the incident. The Sheriff's Department says if it's not a government-issued letter or an in-person visit, this is likely a scam.
The biggest thing is just to let people know that it's happening so that they don't become the next victim. Unfortunately, we have had several, and these scammers can be very convincing, and we just want to make sure that we're getting the word out to the public as much as we can.
The Sheriff's Department wants to remind you to never give out your personal information over the phone and to never give money to someone who calls you. Well, guys, coming up in the next half hour, we're going to hear more from the Sheriff's Department on what you can do if you get scammed and the best way to report it.
All right, Taylor Lazenby, thank you. Check this video out here from eastern Wisconsin. Snowy near whiteout conditions yesterday on I-41 near Keewaskum. This is right in between Oshkosh and Milwaukee. Look at all of the slide-offs and the jackknives. Wow. And here you're going to see a snowplow go right off the road. The driver of this car somehow made it through untouched. Washington County officials say one person was killed and several others are injured.
This is probably 10 plus between a scale between the 1 and 10. And this is probably the worst one I've seen. That could have been me or a family member. I mean, it's sad that somebody had to lose their life.
Authorities say they saw several of these chain reaction crashes yesterday.
Just incredible video. Chris Reese actually gave us the first warn about this particular area that it would be hit hard yesterday, right, Chris?
Yeah, certified most accurate. We talked about that area between Madison, Milwaukee, up towards Sheboygan being the area to watch for slick road conditions as that snow came through yesterday. Now it's a completely different story. Sunshine is abundant this morning. Look at that beautiful sunrise starting to take shape right here over the Madison area. I'll tell you what, three things to know. We're going to be turning up the temperatures as we go throughout your forecast. At the same time, we are getting ready to watch a stormy set up into early next week. Let's go ahead and break down what I expect for Monday and Tuesday. Monday and Tuesday, we'll see a warm front just back towards the south and west. As it moves in, we're going to see highs into the upper 60s and 70s. Clouds will be on the increase, though. As this moves in, then we start to work our way into Tuesday and Wednesday, we will start to see changes. By the way, this warm front, this is going to be a real kicker as we move into Monday because it allows that warm and unstable air to move into southern Wisconsin. By Tuesday, that area low pressure gets closer. It unzips that warm and unstable air. That's what we'll see. More showers and thunderstorms begin to develop right here over the 608. Here's what we're watching right now, though. High pressure is in control after the cold fronts that moved on through. For the weekend, we're going to be watching these two areas of low pressure. That's going to lead to some rain chances for your Friday as they move closer to the Badger State. Here we are Friday morning. You see those showers and thunderstorms developing towards the west. We'll see scattered showers pretty much off and on throughout your Friday. That being said, high resolution radar, it gets to relax today. We've seen a couple of flurries out there. They will not be a big deal. In fact, that's all turning off. Temperatures are cooler, though, with the clear skies that we had overnight. 24 in Madison right now. Wautoma at 18. Black River Falls at 15. But the air is calm, and you do see that sunshine out there. As you plan your day, look for more of it. Temperatures will be warming up into the upper 50s for those highs, and that comes our direction right around 4 to 5 o'clock or so. Then as we push forward into tonight, you'll see the clouds on the increase. This is now 4:30 in the morning. You see where our shower chances have moved into the picture. By 12:30 tomorrow, this is when showers are going to be most widespread. Temperatures are into the low 50s at this point. We'll see the spotty showers all the way through the afternoon. Still cloudy with the chance of rain into early Saturday. We'll see a little bit more sunshine on Sunday. We'll start off the week dry. Then we will see that warm temperature, 77 into Tuesday before those showers and thunderstorms really ramp up Tuesday night and into Wednesday. First warn traffic for you if you are headed out the door this morning. No big issues are showing up on Madison roadways. This is good news. I'm going to point this out every day. There's still the construction right here along the Beltline. Take it easy there so we don't have any other major issues. In Rock County, all looks well.
Mr. Reese, thanks for keeping an eye on that for us. 608 now, Madison Mayor Satya Rhodes Conway is celebrating Earth Day today with a new climate initiative. It outlines different actions the city will take over the next 2 years, including reducing emissions, improving the city's use of renewable energy, and creating more green jobs. In a press release, Rhodes Conway said she believes Madison is ready to accelerate climate action for the benefit of our community and our world. And you can celebrate Earth Day today by volunteering at a local park. Dane County Parks is hosting restoration activities today at Prairie Moraine County Park in Verona. The event aims to clean up the park, do some seed planting and forestry work too. The event will take place all day with speakers scheduled to start at 2. The dog park portion will be closed to the public though until 3 p.m. And a movement to reduce food waste by turning tossed products into something new is on the rise. Upcycling is a way to take wasted food and create something new and nutritious out of it. About 1.3 billion tons of food are wasted every year globally. The Upcycled Food Association represents over 100 businesses across 20 countries. They unveiled a new label for Earth Day, certifying that products have a net positive impact on the environment.
Sounds like a great initiative, but this stuff just does not look good.
I wasn't going to call it appetizing. I'll give you that.
Ugh. Kind of looks like cat food.
Happy Earth Day.
I don't know.
6:09 now. Coming up, there is a new bill to combat hate crimes across America.
And Josh Spreider is going to introduce you to Karaoke Matt. How he's making a positive change in the city.
Get ready to save. This weekend, the Ashley Home Store off the Beltline in Madison is hosting a massive warehouse liquidation sale. Save as much as 90% off store-wide. Shop clearance items, floor samples, special buys, and more. Friday through Monday only at Ashley Home Store.
Get your lawn off to a great start this spring with John Garden Center. It's time to apply fertilizer and weed control, including crabgrass preventer. And Jung has the lawn care supplies you need. Open 7 days a week. Shop John Garden Center today.
More than ever, America needs healthcare workers. So if you're ready to answer the call, Herzing University empowers you to earn the skills you need for all kinds of healthcare careers, including programs that can be completed in 10 months. Accredited and transfer-friendly, Herzing provides the personal care and support you need to succeed. We'll even waive your enrollment fee. Your nation needs healthcare workers. Join the movement at Herzing University. Call or click today.
In America, the future belongs to everyone. So we built the truck of the future for everyone. Ford F-150, with best-in-class available towing and payload and an available interior work surface, is built to work hard and smart. Because the truck of the future isn't built for a few, it's built for America. Ford F-150. Drive one today. Now, get $5,000 total cash on a built Ford Tough F-150. Only at your Wisconsin and UP Ford dealers.
Buying your first home is the start of realizing bigger dreams with your family. That's why it's important to protect everything you love with American Family Insurance. Wait, what's that?
It's their dream car.
Oh, Nice.
Yeah, it's actually my dream car. And my little dream tire swing with some dream trees. There'd be a nice dream garden right here too.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance.
Insure carefully, dream fearlessly.
American Family Insurance.
From working out to catching up, and of course, game night. Your home is the foundation for all of life's awesome moments. This is Tom Coyle. My family and I say thank you. We're proud to be a part of this community for 76 years. During our anniversary event, standard carpet installation is just $76. Carpet one room or your whole house, and we'll install it for only $76. Coyle Carpet One Floor and Home, locally owned and operated since 1945.
Get your lawn off to a great start this spring with Jung Garden Center. It's time to apply fertilizer and weed control, including crabgrass preventer. And Jung has the lawn care supplies you need. Open 7 days a week. Shop Jung Garden Center today.
The 48-hour flash price sale is through Monday at Ashley Home Store. Get limited-time deals we've never offered before, like up to 71% off doorbusters like these. Take a bonus 10% off, then take another 10% off when you finance interest-free till October. Ashley Home Store.
Welcome back. There is a man right here in the 608 working to make a difference day after day, but it's how he's doing it that has a lot of people talking.
Josh Spreider is here now to introduce us to Karaoke Matt. What a cool story.
Hey guys, good morning. Yeah, this guy is quite the character. It was so fun to be able to meet him. And the guy that you're about to meet right now, he's a husband, father, and quite the hard worker, but it's his sense of humor and positive attitude I think all of us here in the 608 can learn from.
She has no idea what's coming.
You may have seen his videos floating around on social media. So welcome to my house. You'll find Matt Willey working as a street operator for the city of Madison, where he's been for the last 5 years. But that's just his day job.
My old lady's thrown out everything out.
I joke with my buddies like, oh, I'm a local celebrity, and they hate it. You know, because they have to deal with it every day. I sing to them.
So where am I going to live when I get home?
You heard that right. He sings, too. Matt started performing when he was around 10 years old. The Whitewater native did his first competition for the Walworth County Fair that led him to compete on American Idol and The Voice. But it was a singing competition on Q106 in Madison when he first got the nickname Karaoke Matt.
I've always been one that I wanted to entertain, you know, I want to sing. That's my passion is to sing. But this is second best.
It's that name which pushed him into making more of a positive difference in the community. And that really began while he was helping a friend with a roofing job.
As a joke, I told him to take a picture of me holding a nail gun. So when he showed me the picture, I'm like, that's a calendar pose right there.
So from there, every job that Matt went to help out with, he did a new pose, all the way up to 12.
You know, I don't have the abs or anything like that, but I can make you smile and I can make you laugh, and that's where the calendar came in.
And with the help of family and friends, they made a batch of 50 calendars, which were snatched up right away.
The next batch of calendars, I wanted to kind of step it up a little bit.
Matt then turned to small businesses, showing his support through the pandemic.
These small businesses that are going out of business because of COVID is what really kind of wanted me to promote small businesses and help charities in the local community.
Matt says he couldn't believe the response in them wanting to buy ad space in his calendar.
I was able to take that money and donate to the Children's Hospital, Project Home, some local GoFundMes, or just simply paying it forward.
So here's everything we're able to come and donate today.
Through word of mouth and social media, people from all across the Madison area began donating to the Karaoke Matt Fund, with Q106 in Madison helping out Matt as well.
During this pandemic, they had no concert tickets to give away, so they needed something to give to the listeners to kind of keep them, you know, reeled in, and what better than Karaoke Matt calendars.
Now you can find all his merchandise online, with all of the money donated going straight back into the community. Matt's been able to help so many people in need, recently delivering about 80 Easter baskets to families across the 608.
Hello, hope you guys have a happy Easter.
Someone's business, someone's life, you know, and that's what people got to think about is, It's not a competition. It's not a battle.
He's happy to finally have the platform to make a positive difference.
We come together and we help each other out, because if I was in need, I would hope people would want to do that for me too, you know.
Matt is working on a brand new project right now called Lawn Care for Vets. They're looking for vets who aren't able to afford doing their own yard this summer, or maybe not able to do it themselves. I posted links up on the Channel 3000 mobile app where you can find Matt's contact info and also all of his merchandise for sale. Remember, all of that goes right back into the community. And guys, he was able to raise $5,000 within the first 6 months of him doing this whole Karaoke Matt Fund. $5,000, and every single one of those dollars goes right back into the community. And like I mentioned, he donated to the Children's Hospital, Project Home. Now he's working on that lawn care for vets. And he also has supported local GoFundMes, too, of families that have been going through a hard time, or some businesses that have been close to closing. So, I mean, this guy, quite the character, and he's the jack of all trades, too. He can sing, he can do it all.
Yeah, what a great attitude. I think we can all learn something from him. You know, he made a really good point there at the end of the piece that, you know, this could very well as easily be him in a tough situation and him needing help. So he's paying it back. So with this new program, this Lawn Care for Vets program they're going to do this summer, are we going to see Matt out cutting grass this year?
And singing.
Yes, yeah, you're going to see him out there. He's working with a local lawn care service company and doing that too. So it's just super cool to see. You know, it started off as him trying to support these local businesses, but then these local businesses wanted to partner with him and also give back to the community. So that just goes to show how people here in the 608 are more worried about other people versus themselves, which is just great. And we can just have that community even more, you know, substantial. We can thrive that much more, especially during these difficult times, guys.
You said it, Josh. Thanks a lot.
Oh, one of my favorite stories in the morning. Remember to let Josh know what inspires you in the 608. You can reach out to him on social media or shoot him an email for a chance to be featured.
All right, Chris Reese here now with a look at that Thursday forecast. We are starting off real chilly this morning, Chris.
Starting off chilly indeed, but today is the day that we start to see changes and we really start to feel a little bit warmer into our afternoons. 24, though, that's where we start in Juneau, the Dells, even right here in Madison. 23 in Watertown right now. 34, though, as you work your way over towards Mineral Point. Here's what to expect as we look ahead. Temperatures are into the 40s by the time we get you towards 10 o'clock. 50s arrive by lunchtime today, and we will continue to warm up from there. Look at all the sunshine that you see on that forecast. In fact, high resolution radar, it's quieting down. We did see a couple of snow showers towards the south and west early this morning. Those are now out of here. 58 today, a little cooler for the weekend, 77 by the time we get you towards Tuesday. We're really going to see a warm up next week. We're going to break down that shower and thunderstorm chance, the multiple shower and thunderstorm chances coming up.
All right, Mr. Reese, thanks for tracking it. 6:19 now. Later today, the U.S. Senate is set to vote on the COVID-19 Hate Crimes Act. The bill was created to address the rise in anti-Asian hate crimes by allowing the Justice Department to respond faster to them. The bill is expected to pass with bipartisan support.
New statistics out this morning from the Bureau of Labor shows that nearly 10% of American families struggled with unemployment last year. One out of every 10 people had at least one unemployed family member in the last year. That was double the number from 2019. In total, more than 8 million families experienced a job loss last year.
UW-Madison is preparing for the summer semester as another virtual school year comes to an end. The campus community is taking some small and hopeful steps toward a new normal, though. The spring semester introduced the Badger Badge. We've talked a lot about this, requiring students and staff to present a recent negative COVID test to access all buildings. Well, now it's only going to be required to enter specific buildings, and testing frequency for students and staff, that's going to go down to one day a week. 6:20 now. Up next, we take a look at the future of bartending, and it might be a little less personable.
And coming up in our next half hour, some new research out this morning on the COVID vaccine and women who are pregnant, the most common side effect. Stay with us.
Get the Barnes four-step lawn care program by scheduling a free consultation with a Barnes licensed lawn care professional. From planting to pruning, seeding to sodding, mowing to mulching, and everything in between. Barnes since 1981. Get started today at barnesinc.net.
Cobison Buses, now hiring.
Working with Cobison, it's definitely been great because of the flexibility. If you do need time off, they work around you. They definitely try to make it a company that's based for you.
Visit cobison.com to apply.
It's spring, the perfect time to update your home. And right now, during Steinhoffel's Room Design Event, you can save 35 to 50% on all the latest styles and trends. And with Steinhoffel's decorating solutions, our designers will help make refreshing your home a breeze. Steinhoffel's has the largest selection of in-stock furniture and mattresses, all under one roof. The Room Design Event, only at Steinhoffel's and steinhoffels.com.
Announcing another Best of Madison 2021 finalist. And the nominee is Fry Construction, Best Kitchen and Bath Design, Best Roofer. Vote for Fry Construction today at madisonmagazine.com.
Medical bills. Missed time at work. Life-changing injuries. Household expenses. When you're the victim of an accident, it can feel like the weight of the entire world is on your shoulders. But we've dedicated our personal injury law firm to help take this crippling burden off your back. Habish, Habish, and Rotier. We fight for what's right.
Is your credit score getting in the way of things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit help you borrow up to $10,000. So check your eligibility on netcredit.com today without affecting your credit score. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal, personal loan.
Just announced, East Madison Toyota just acquired 11 truckloads of used inventory. So if you've been waiting for the perfect time to buy pre-owned, it's here at East Madison Toyota. Check out our Toyota certified used selection with special APRs, plus a 7-year, 100,000-mile factory-backed warranty. Experience the e-Vantage online at eastmadisontoyota.com or come see us at East Madison Toyota off I-90 and 151.
Cobison Buses, now hiring.
After we backed that bus out of its stall and started driving, I just loved it. We really get a chance to get to know each other. Almost everyone has a different story about how they came to bus driving. So you really end up feeling like you're part of a family.
Visit Cobison.com to apply.
Get the Barnes four-step lawn care program by scheduling a free consultation with a Barnes licensed lawn care professional. From planting to pruning, seeding to sodding, mowing to mulching, and everything in between. Barnes since 1981. Get started today at barnesinc.net.
We'd like to thank Julie for sharing her morning with us. She sent a lovely photo in of the reflection off the creek. You say creek, right? Don't you?
Creek.
Creek.
Crick.
Crick.
Is it crick or creek for
Depends
you?
Depends on where I am.
You're an island, you call them crick. That's funny. Hey, Julie, thanks for sending in this picture this morning. You can share your photos with us, too. Just post them on our social media pages. Use the hashtag MyNews3Morning.
Just a gorgeous photo,
it
Julie.
Is.
Okay, a Swiss company is offering up a new way for you to enjoy your cocktail hour. F&P Robotics has created this fully automated bartender that can mix dozens of cocktails and even mix in some terrible jokes. The Barney Bar can mix up to 16 different drinks and sodas. You can order via your phone. The robot can even disinfect its own arms. The company is also in development of a barista version, if you think that's less creepy.
I'll take a real person behind the bar any day
yes,
over this thing.
Yes, sir, 100%.
Yeah, you just don't get the same experience, and that's part of the reason you go to the tavern, right? Is you want that experience, and you want to be able to talk to another human. And
Wouldn't you just be a little freaked out? This, like, you know, humanless arm moving around,
yeah, it would,
telling
yeah.
you bad it's jokes. Just,
come on.
Where's the sound come out of?
We need a robot for everything now?
No.
I just don't get it.
Pass. Hard.
Yeah, me too. Chris Ray, 625, and what, we're right about 25 degrees
yeah.
outside this morning, aren't we?
Just below that, our temperature sits at 24 right now, and that's with a calm wind. So that's some good news for us, but yep, it's certainly chilly out there. We're going to keep that chilly air around for quite some time. 27 in Janesville at the moment, 32 as you work your way over towards Monroe. Meanwhile, Mineral Point sits in at 34. We've seen temperatures out west be a little bit warmer this morning. The reason for that is they had a little bit of cloud cover because we tracked a little bit of flurry activity out there overnight and early this morning. That's coming to an end, so that's not going to be a big deal as we go throughout the rest of today. In fact, as you plan out your day, we're going to warm up. And we're going to warm up well. The warmest we've been seemingly all week. Look for temperatures topping out into the upper 50s for those highs this afternoon, folks. Even at dinner time, we'll keep those temperatures into the mid-50s with abundant sunshine.
All right. Thank you, Chris. Stick around, folks. News 3 Now this morning. We'll be back right after this.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Herzing University empowers you to earn the skills you need for all kinds of healthcare careers. Right now, we'll even waive your enrollment fee. Your nation needs healthcare workers. Join the movement at Herzing University. Call or click today.
Get more enjoyment from your outdoor space with patio enclosures. Right now, get 25% off your sunroom. Plus, no interest if paid in full in 2 years. Call today.
Patio enclosures.
They say when you come from a small town, you grow up a little different. When U.S. Cellular's founder, Roy Carlson, looked at small towns, he saw nothing but potential. Potential that deserved the best technology. Since the other guys were busy with the biggest cities, well, he'd just have to build a network there himself. Here's the thing. When you create a network as a local, you know the dead spots, so you fix them. You know the neighbors, so you're good to them. Did you drop these? You know the local neighborhood, so you make a difference.
Thanks for the hot spot.
When you go town by town doing it different, you might even win some awards. You might even want to celebrate. But we're still far from done. You know, it's a good thing we started local. Otherwise, we might not be a little different. The nationwide network built from your town up, U.S. Cellular.
Refresh your space and save now at H&R Carpets and Flooring. Our renewable, recyclable flooring by Shaw Floors is easy care. It's perfect for kids and pets, couples that cook, and for those that love the comfort of home. Tile, soft carpets, and stunning hardwood. Is it time for new flooring at your house? Refresh your space now and save up to $1,000. Plus, get special financing for up to 36 months. Come see us at H&R Carpets and Flooring in Wanakee.
Dear Freedom, being parked inside has many wanting to ride unleashed. We say let's go, faster and further, leading the pack, revving with power, with the confidence that tomorrow's road will be better than today's. Let's go, Toyota Hybrids.
Right now, you can lease a new 2021 Venza Hybrid for $249 a month. find yours at Toyota.com. Toyota, let's go places.
Get more enjoyment from your outdoor space with patio enclosures. Right now, get 25% off your sunroom. Plus, no interest if paid in full in 2 years. Call today.
Patio Enclosures.
If a nurse is what you want to be, let Herzing University make it possible in lots of different ways. We'll even waive your enrollment fee. Be exactly the nurse you want to be.
I'm possible at Herzing.
Call or click today.
Police training and transparency. We have an exclusive look at a program hoping to reduce deadly outcomes in our own community.
And breaking overnight, two killed, one airlifted in an overnight shooting in Mississippi. What police say could have led up to it.
We're planning out your day, plus tracking a stormy setup for early next week. We're breaking it all down in the First One forecast.
This is News 3 Now This Morning.
Good morning, everybody. Thanks for waking up with us on your Thursday. I'm Leah Lynch-Eye.
And I'm Chris Stanford. Police reform and transparency and how it's done is top of mind for the entire country right now. And News 3 Now got an exclusive look at some of the crisis training that Madison area police officers will get this summer. The people in this training video aren't police officers, but they're taking some of the same training that local officers will receive. It's run by the National Alliance on Mental Illness. The crisis intervention training adapts with the times. Leaders say the training will prevent police shootings.
Officers are dealing with situations that they really don't have the training for. And so if we can help people that are dealing with mental health crises, that are dealing with ALDA issues and things like that, that's going to help, keep our community safer.
Here's a list of some of the topics covered in the two-day training for community crisis intervention partners. It includes topics like trauma-informed care, mental illness, de-escalation, and autism spectrum, as well as implicit bias. The training for police officers will be 5 days long.
We are following some breaking news at this hour. At least two people are dead after a shooting in Columbus, Mississippi. It happened around 9:30 last night. The Columbus police chief says the victims are a man and a woman. At least one other person injured. They had to be airlifted from the area for treatment. Authorities believe the shooting is related to what they're calling a domestic situation. We will continue to update you as we learn more this morning. And new protests in Columbus, Ohio, reaching into the night after an officer-involved shooting there. Officer Nicholas Reardon shot and killed 16-year-old Micaiah Bryant Tuesday afternoon while police were responding to a call for a possible stabbing. Protesters marched all day yesterday and held a vigil for the girl. Some gathered outside the police headquarters late in the night, setting fireworks off in the street. Now, body camera video recently released by police shows the teen appearing to try to stab a woman with a knife before she was shot several times. Columbus's interim police chief says an officer can use deadly force when the subject appears to be hurting someone else, but a more thorough investigation is needed before they decide whether the shooting was justified.
Protesters in North Carolina are demanding transparency after a county deputy shot and killed a man while executing a search warrant. It happened in Elizabeth City Wednesday morning. Witnesses say the deputy shot at Andrew Brown Jr., who was driving away from authorities. Witnesses tell our affiliate there that they heard 6 to 8 gunshots. County officials have yet to release the body camera video. The local NAACP wants it released right away.
We're not going away until we get some cooperation, until we get some transparency. What are you hiding?
Protesters say they'll go back to the county sheriff's office this evening if the body camera video hasn't been released by then.
Family and friends of Dante Wright are preparing to say their final goodbyes today. The 20-year-old will be laid to rest this afternoon. Hundreds of mourners turned out last night for a public viewing. Former officer Kim Potter shot and killed Wright back on April 11th during a traffic stop in Brooklyn Center. She's now facing a second-degree manslaughter charge. Reverend Al Sharpton will give the eulogy, just as he did for George Floyd. Members of Floyd's family will also be in attendance.
Civilian staffers for the Madison Police Department are at odds with the city council this morning over its decision to restructure. The council has decided to transfer nearly 30 parking enforcement officers out of the police department to the city's parking utilities division. Now, the move will take nearly 2 years to finalize. Alder Keith Furman says it's a way to show the public that they're serious about rethinking public safety. Current staffers say it puts an unnecessary financial burden on the city.
I think we ask our police department to do entirely too much, and I don't think the outcomes are as best as they can be.
Law enforcement programs that we have access to now are all going away.
and MPD pays for that. We're kind of under their umbrella, and we're going to be duplicated. The city is going to be duplicating some of those expenses.
That parking enforcement officer says they also rely on MPD for backup in dangerous situations. Under the new structure, they won't have immediate access to backup. Alder Furman says even if it costs the city more money, it's worth it to get better outcomes.
Today is Earth Day, and some local hospitals are hoping to help you celebrate. SSM Health and Dean Health are offering up free trees for you to take home. The giveaway is happening in two locations, Badger Prairie County Park in Verona and Lunny Lake Farm County Park in Madison. They'll hand out the jack pine saplings on a first-come, first-served basis from 3 until 6 this evening.
Governor Evers is reintroducing legislation to address statewide PFAS contamination.
No matter where people live, whether it's the Central Sands in Wisconsin or the heart of our urban areas or right here in the Driftless, every Wisconsinite should be able to turn on the water in the morning and have it come out of their tap clean, period.
It's called the CLEAR Act. It would enforce statewide PFAS standards, providing funding for PFAS testing and would help monitoring and mitigation efforts. Governor Evers says the state is currently monitoring areas in La Crosse, Madison, and Marinette.
6:35 now. Chris Reese is here with our certified most accurate forecast in Madison. Hey, Chris.
Good morning, folks. We have seen an incredible sunrise. I wish you could have seen 30 minutes ago and just how red and orange this picture was. But it's a beautiful day that we're expecting right here in the 608. We're turning up the temperatures really as we go throughout your entire extended forecast. But we are going to be watching chances for showers into the weekend and thunder. And that's set up in early next week. In fact, let's go ahead and break down what to expect for then. Monday and Tuesday, we're going to watch this warm front off towards the south and west as it moves forward. We're talking highs in the upper 60s and 70s, and then cloud cover will be on the increase. In fact, one good period to watch, that's going to be Monday afternoon. This is when that warm front is now north of our area. This is what we call the warm sector. All that warmth, the moisture, the instability, it gets pumped in to southern Wisconsin. But Tuesday and Wednesday, that area low pressure gets closer, that unzips all that moisture and instability, and that leads to more chances for the showers and the thunderstorms. But I also mentioned we have a rain chance as we move into the weekend. Let's talk about the setup out there right now and how that's going to lead to our shower chances. High pressure is in control at the moment. That's why we have the sunshine out there today. It's these two areas of low pressure I'm watching. As they get closer towards the upper Midwest, it creates enough rising air in the atmosphere that things are going to be unsettled for us as we go through the next couple of days. Here's that cold front getting closer as we move into your Friday, and that means the off and on shower chances are something to expect out there tomorrow. Thankfully, we are quiet today, so enjoy that. Clear skies are in play for us here throughout all of southern Wisconsin, and temperatures are cool as you begin to step out the door. 24 in Madison right now, Wautoma at 18, but we're at 32 as you work your way over towards Monroe. Thankfully, the wind chill is in line with their actual air temperature. It truly is a calm and quiet morning out there. As you plan the day, look for more sunshine. Temperatures top out into the upper 50s. That comes likely right around 4 or 5 o'clock. Even at dinner time, though, 7 o'clock, we're keeping those temperatures into the mid-50s. We're focused in closer to home, taking you hour by hour. Here's that afternoon high. Watch how clouds start to increase overnight. So this is now 4:30 in the morning. Tomorrow, a couple of showers. This is where the first signs of the shower activity will begin to move into the picture, but it's lunchtime tomorrow, 12:30, that I'm most concerned about for the most widespread shower coverage and intensity around here. But even beyond lunchtime tomorrow, we will keep the scattered and isolated showers in the picture as temperatures only top out into the lower 50s for your Friday. We're back into the upper 50s on Saturday, low 50s on Sunday. Then the real warm-up comes our way with that warm front on Monday. 69 for your high, 77 on Tuesday. Showers and thunderstorms, though, to follow that up with the cold front that'll keep us back into the 50s by next Thursday. Traffic-wise, we're always watching First Warn traffic here in the First Warn Weather Center, and things are all quiet for the most part. We do have the construction on the Beltline. Please take it easy if you're going through there. Otherwise, Dane County and Rock County, You're all in phenomenal shape on the roads this morning.
Thanks, Chris. News 3 Now is your vaccination headquarters, and a new study suggests that COVID vaccines do not pose a serious risk to expecting mothers. Researchers reviewed data from more than 35,000 pregnant women from December through February, and they found that the most common side effect from the vaccine was pain at the injection site. The symptoms appeared more frequently in vaccine recipients who were pregnant. Other symptoms like headaches, muscle aches, chills, and fever were reported less frequently. The study is published in the New England Journal of Medicine.
It might be finally easier to schedule your COVID-19 vaccine appointment, but a lot of that depends on where you live. SSM Health, which has vaccination clinics across our area, tells us demand is much higher in Dane County compared to some surrounding counties. Dane County also has an above average percentage of residents who've gotten one shot compared to the rest of the state. Rock, Dodge, and Jefferson counties, meanwhile, are falling below.
We've had far fewer people signing up. We maybe have three or four people signing up each day, as opposed to the hundreds and, you know, thousands that were registering in the first few weeks. And we're having a lot of trouble filling those appointments.
Coming up tonight on News 3 Now at 10, Madeline O'Neill dives into the differences in supply and demand between counties and vaccinators' efforts to get those shots out.
Pfizer issuing a warning about counterfeit versions of its COVID-19 vaccine. The company says the shots have been identified in Mexico and Poland so far. They say no legitimate vaccine will ever be sold online and that all vaccinations need to be administered at official centers or certified healthcare providers.
6:40 now. People lose a lot of money to phone scams, sometimes amounting to their life savings. But there are ways to avoid falling for them. Taylor Lazenby is here with the call for action by the Dane County Sheriff. Hey there, Taylor.
Hi, Layla. Good morning. That's right. In some instances, scammers act friendly and sometimes they're helpful. In other ways, they are threatening and also try to scare you. But most phone scams tend to make similar promises and threats or ask you to pay in certain ways. Now, it's best to never give out your personal information over the phone and to never give money to someone who calls you. If you have been a victim of such of these scams, the Dane County Sheriff's Office wants to encourage you to report that crime as soon as you spot one or feel like you've been scammed.
Sometimes they are, you know, using phone numbers that appear to be local, but they're not. So the best thing to do is just hang up, not respond in any way. Of course, never give out any personal information.
Now, Schaefer says if you do get scammed by a scammer, they say the best thing to do is try to get that phone number. Also try to get some key descriptive facts about the scammer, maybe their tone of their voice. Sometimes she says if they come to your residence, their article of clothing. She said this can all help in their investigation process. And for more information on this scam and others, you can visit our website. That's at channel3000.com.
Taylor Lazenby, thank you very much.
Looking outside this morning as the sun comes up, we are starting off really chilly. It's going to warm up a bit today. We'll see sun, but how long is it going to stick around? Chris Reese with that in your First Warn forecast.
Plus, you might know Karaoke Matt from his voice on Q106, but the rest of the country knows him from his TikToks and what he's trying to do for our community. Josh shares his story next in the 608.
Don't miss A1 Furniture's 4-day flash sale. This Thursday through Sunday only, get 19% off everything in the store. Sofas from $3.99, sectionals from $5.99, plus get 1 year free financing. The 4-day flash sale, only at A1 Furniture and Mattress.
From working out to catching up, and of course, game night. Your home is the foundation for all of life's awesome moments. This is Tom Coyle. My family and I say thank you. We're proud to be a part of this community for 76 years. During our anniversary event, standard carpet installation is just $76. Carpet one room or your whole house, and we'll install it for only $76. Coyle Carpet One Floor and Home, locally owned and operated since 1945.
Isn't it great how swinging through Culver's drive-thru marks the unofficial start to family time? How biting into a hot-off-the-grill butter burger makes worries melt away? And how a fresh frozen custard concrete mixer puts a smile on your face every time? Here, a meal you didn't have to make is a meal made fresh for you. And being greeted with a smile, even beneath a mask, makes all the difference.
There's a reason we put so much care into our food. That reason is you.
Welcome to Delicious.
Everything is relative. Travel, for example. A trip to Stoughton might seem like a long way, but if you're shopping for diamonds, it's closer than you think.
Diamond Select.
Importers of shimmering diamonds from the mines of South Africa to the streets of Antwerp and Tel Aviv. They shop the diamond capitals of the world so you don't have to.
Diamond Select. Direct pricing saves you money.
On GIA certified South African diamonds.
Diamond Select.
Downtown Stoughton.
Americans have been cutting the lawn for 100 years, but with TurfBot's mowing service, the future of mowing is now. Our quiet, all-electric robotic mowers work around the clock to keep your lawn trimmed 24/7. That means less time spent mowing and more time spent enjoying. Equipped with LED headlights, auto-stop sensors, and anti-theft GPS devices, our mowers run safely with no supervision. Come home to a freshly mowed lawn every day for as little as $24 a week. Call today to request your free demo or get a quote. TurfBot.
Don't miss A1 Furniture's 4-day flash sale. This Thursday through Sunday only. Get 19% off all mattresses store-wide. Queen mattresses just $249. Mattresses and adjustable base both for only $599. Plus get 1 year free financing. Only at A1 Furniture and Mattress.
Tonight on CBS, an all-new night of comedy begins with Young Sheldon at 7. At 7:30, Al is exasperated by Riley's parenting style with Hazel, so he attempts to teach Hazel to be more deferential to her elders on United States of Al. Then it's Mom at 8, Be Positive at 8:30, and Clarice at 9, followed by News 3 Now at 10, the latest news and weather you need to have before you go to sleep tonight.
There's a man right here in the 608 making a difference every day, but it's how he's doing that that has a lot of people talking.
Josh Brider joining us with his story. Good morning, Josh.
Hey, guys. Good morning. You may have heard Karaoke Matt sing on Q106 before. You'll also find him in the streets department at the city of Madison. He's becoming quite the name, not only here in the 608, but across the country for his efforts in helping out our local community. Matt Willie is probably best known for his videos on TikTok, which is a popular platform right now. The 30-year-old Whitewater native has spent more than a year working to support local businesses and those in need during the pandemic. It started off with him selling these calendars, similar to the firefighter calendars you're probably familiar with already. It's a way to spread some smiles and lighten the mood, but it's turned into so much more than that.
I've always been one that I wanted to entertain. You know, I want to sing. That's my passion, is to sing. But this is second best. You know, I mean, this is something that I love to do. It gives me a fulfillment of something that is needed around here.
Matt is using all of the money donated through his calendars and giving back to those in need here in the 608. Now he even has all sorts of merchandise up for sale on his websites, like shirts and hats, tank tops, you name it. You can find a link on the Channel 3000 mobile app if you'd like to check him out. And he's always working on new ways to help out local folks, guys. Right now he's working on a new project called Lawn Care for Vets. And they're working to find vets who aren't able to afford doing their own yard or aren't able to do it themselves. Matt's thankful to have such a supportive family during this. He says he couldn't have done it without his wife and his son by his side every step of the way. Just an incredible guy. You know, he was texting me this morning that he's already gotten some feedback from people this morning, and just seeing that positive difference in that community. You can see that positive wave kind of spreading, especially during these times. We need that, right? Any extra way that we can get that smile and every extra way that we can make that difference right now is pretty crucial, guys.
You're absolutely right, Josh. That gentleman's going to have me downloading TikTok. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I think he's going to sell a few more calendars, too.
Oh, yeah.
Thanks, Job. Loves what he's doing for vets this summer. All right, let's check in with Chris Reese and your First Warn forecast. Hey, Chris.
Good morning, folks. We are still chilly out there, but that sun is rising. That means temperatures are getting ready to do the same. Clear skies overnight. That helped temperatures drop to 24 in Madison. Check out Wautoma, 18. Black River Falls at 16. Cloud cover over the Driftless region with some snow showers and flurries allowed them to stay just a little bit warmer as we went through the overnight hours. As we warm up throughout your morning, 43 by 10 a.m., 50s arrive in time for your lunch. Here's high resolution radar, though. You see where they had a couple of snow showers. Still a little bit of them show up mainly south and west of Platteville, over around Dubuque in Iowa. We're generally going to get rid of this as we go throughout the day. That does mean sunshine for all. Temperatures are on a big increase, though, as we move towards Tuesday next week.
All right. Thanks, Chris. Stick around. The morning sprint is coming up after the break.
But first, if you have a little kid turning three soon, let us know so we can share their picture on TV. Thanks for watching News 3 Now this morning.
Look Who's 3 is sponsored by Three Bears Resort, Indoor Water Park and Conference Center in Warrens, Wisconsin.
Get the Barnes 4-Step Lawn Care Program by scheduling a free consultation with a Barnes licensed lawn care professional. From planting to pruning, seeding to sodding, mowing to mulching, and everything in between. Barnes since 1981. Get started today at barnesinc.net.
McGann Furniture in downtown Baraboo should probably be called McGann Furniture and Flooring because we're the area's oldest and most experienced floor covering store. Our friendly staff will explain the many types of flooring available, answer questions, and make suggestions so you can choose what's best for your home and lifestyle. We always offer free in-home measurements and estimates and use the finest installers in the entire area. And remember, at McGann, we don't inflate prices only to mark them down for a sale. Stop in today and discover the difference. You'll be glad you did. McGann Furniture, downtown Baraboo.
If a nurse is what you want to be, let Herzing University make it possible in lots of different ways. Whether you're planning to become a nurse for the first time or take your nursing career to the next level, Herzing offers learning options and a choice of nursing pathways, all with personal care and support. We'll even waive your enrollment fee. Be exactly the nurse you want to be.
I'm possible at Herzing.
I'm possible at Herzing.
I'm possible at Herzing.
I'm possible at Herzing.
Call or click today.
It takes attention to detail. With your local Bryant dealer, you're getting more than just a technician. You're getting someone who pays attention to your needs and the little things that make a big difference. It takes a dealer you can rely on. And to keep your family cool this summer,
let me show you how this works.
It takes Bryant.
Bryant, whatever it takes.
In the Fitchburg area, contact Tarkenton Brothers Heating, Ventilating, and Air Conditioning for quality comfort solutions.
Goldman Cars is breaking into spring with huge savings. You can get a 2016 or 17 Ford Escape starting at $10,995 or $175 per month.
That's right. You can buy a 2016 or 17 Ford Escape only for $10,995 or $175 per month.
Don't miss out on these huge spring deals with over 500 vehicles in stock.
So just hurry in today and ask for my sister, Crystal the Pistol Govan.
Or my brother, Dealing Donovan Govan.
You gotta go to Govan. GovanCars.com.
Barnes 4-Step Lawn Care Program by scheduling a free consultation with a Barnes licensed lawn care professional. From planting to pruning, seeding to sodding, mowing to mulching, and everything in between. Barnes since 1981. Get started today at barnesinc.net.
First Warn Weather, certified most accurate forecast.
6:51, time for the morning sprint.
Today marks 1 month since the mass shooting in Boulder, Colorado that left 10 dead. The suspect, Ahmed Al-Alawi Alyssa, is facing 43 new charges in the shooting. He'd previously been charged with 10 counts of first-degree murder. Alyssa is in police custody at an undisclosed location. Our affiliate in Denver reports he'd been moved from the Boulder County Jail after receiving death threats.
A Kenosha man officially charged this morning with killing three people and injuring three others at a bar last weekend. Investigators say Rakhio Vincent had been kicked out of the Summers House Tavern earlier that night, then returned with a gun. According to the criminal complaint, Vincent told police he'd blacked out before the shooting.
Former Bucks player Sterling Brown is recovering from injuries this morning after someone reportedly assaulted him outside a strip club in Miami. Brown currently plays for the Houston Rockets. The team had been in Miami to play the Heat this week when this all happened. The team says Brown is seeing doctors and working with the training staff as he recovers.
You're taking a live look at the Capitol this morning, where a bill for free college tuition faces some strong opposition. Senator Bernie Sanders and Representative Pramila Jayapal introduced the College for All Act yesterday. It would make college free for families earning less than $125,000 a year. The federal government would pay for 75% of tuition and fees. States would pick up the rest.
The full House of Representatives is expected to vote today on a bill that would make Washington, D.C. the 51st state. House Democrats are expected to pass the Admission Act for the second time in as many years. The bill has more than 200 co-sponsors, but it likely does not have the support to pass the Senate.
A new CBS poll just in the last few minutes shows a majority of Americans approve of President Biden's handling of climate change. The president will meet with about 40 other world leaders today for a virtual climate summit and is expected to announce an aggressive goal of cutting U.S. carbon emissions in half by the end of the decade. Leaders of China and Russia will also be there.
New car prices are soaring. According to J.D. Power, the average price for a new car, more than $37,000 in the first quarter of 2021. That's up more than 8% from this time last year. People returning to work, that's what's fueling the increased demand. At the same time, manufacturers have limited production because of microchip shortages, cutting the supply even more.
A swipe of the palm, that's all it's going to take for some Whole Foods shoppers to check out. Whole Foods is starting to use parent company Amazon's Amazon One technology. It associates your credit card with your palm, coupled with a biometric reader. It's the same technology Amazon's already using in some of its other physical stores. So far, Seattle is the only city using the technology, but they do have plans to expand.
Some children's gummy vitamins are being recalled after two reports of customers finding metallic mesh in the products. The VitaFusion products were sold online and in-store between November of 2020 and April of this year. The recall includes Kids Melatonin, Fiberwell, Sleepwell, and Multivites.
Top-ranked Badgers women's volleyball team, one win away now from making it to the national championship. They're going to play Texas tonight on ESPN at 8:30. Six women on the team have been named to an AVCA All-American team.
The Wisconsin Chamber Orchestra is releasing the lineup for its Concerts on the Square series. Some of the concerts include Disco Inferno and Shakespeare in Love. The musicians will perform at Bree Stevens Field on Wednesday, starting the first week of July. Tickets go on sale closer to Memorial Day. They'll be as low as $5. You can find a full list of performers up on our Channel 3000 mobile app.
28 is now our temperature. Like I said, as soon as that sun comes up, temperatures begin to respond, especially as we go throughout today. Janesville, you're at 28 as well. 29 in Lone Rock, Platteville. You are waking up at 31 this morning. We will continue to see our temperatures increase all day long. That comes with sunshine. The flurries from overnight, those are going to be turning off as we go throughout the day, and the thermometer turns on, warming all the way up into the upper 50s as we move into this afternoon. Even around dinner time, we will keep those temperatures into the mid-50s. So it's going to be mild compared to what we've seen, but the true warm-up, that comes our direction early next week. 69 on Monday, 77 for your high temperature on Tuesday. We're going to be tracking multiple chances for showers and thunderstorms, though. One arrives Friday into Saturday. The next one is going to be Tuesday night, Wednesday, and into Thursday. We're going to watch that chance for thunderstorms closely. I do not foresee the potential for severe weather right now, but nonetheless, it's still several days away. We will let you know what to expect. That's why we are your first warm weather team. We'll keep you up to date as we get closer.
And the most accurate in Madison at that. Thank you, Chris. Next on CBS This Morning, an interview with one of the alternate jurors from the Derek Chauvin trial.